vive, nació y su iglesia en victoria. We are in victory, church, amen.
Estamos en victoria.
Just like what Brother Gustavo said,
así como decía el hermano Gustavo,
the point of the gospel,
el punto del evangelio,
is for all souls to hear it.
Es que las almas vengan a escuchar su palabra.
And God brought us souls tonight, amen. God desires for us to hear his word. God desires for us to hear his word.
Dios desea que escuchemos su palabra.
And he wants us to know that he hasn't given up on us.
Que no se ha, no tirado la toalla,
that he still has a plan for us.
Que todavía tiene un plan para con nosotros.
And I was, as I was hearing the testimonies and the petitions,
y mientras escuchaba las peticiones y los testimonios,
I was deeply encouraged.
Estaba muy animado.
Because there's a lot of faith in here tonight.
Porque hay mucha fe en este, en
there's
este.
A lot of people in here who have a lot of faith in an almighty God.
Hay mucha gente que tiene fe en esta. En esta iglesia, en este momento.
And it's amazing because that's how the Holy Spirit works.
Y es maravilloso cómo funciona el Espíritu Santo.
Because tonight God has given us word.
Porque Dios nos ha traído palabra esta noche.
About a man.
De un hombre.
Who had a great faith in Jesus.
Que tenía una gran fe en Jesús.
And we're going to learn.
Y vamos a aprender.
That all he needed was faith.
Y todo lo que necesitaba era fe.
And his entire life was changed forever.
Y su vida fue cambiada para siempre.
And his story.
Su historia.
His story was so important.
Era tan importante.
That 2,000 years later.
Y después de 2,000 años.
We're going to talk about it tonight.
Vamos a hablar de
ello. Stand with me, church. Saints, stand with me and open your Bibles to Mark chapter 10.
Marcos, capítulo 10.
God has a powerful word for us.
Dios tiene una
and he is ready to pour out his spirit. He's ready to transform lives. I don't know how many of us feel stagnant. I don't know how many of us are wanting to encounter more of our God. But that is my desire for all of us tonight, that we continue to get a taste of God's glory.
As
Mark chapter 10,
Marcos 10,
46 through 52.
46 al 52.
And Pastor Mike, I will read first, and then if you could read after me in Spanish. And it reads, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And they came to Jericho. And as Jesus was leaving Jericho with his disciples and a great crowd, Bartimaeus, a blind beggar, the son of Timaeus, was sitting by the roadside. And when he heard that Jesus of Nazareth was coming, he began to cry out and say, Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me. And then he rebuked him, telling him to be silent. But he cried out all the more, saying, Son of David, have mercy on me. And Jesus stops and said, call him. And they called the blind man, saying to him, take heart, get up. He's calling you. Verse 50. And throwing off his cloak, Bartimaeus sprung up and came to Jesus. And Jesus said to him, what do you want me to do for you? And the blind man said to him, Rabbi, let me recover my sight. And Jesus said to him, go your way. Your faith has made you well. And immediately he recovered his sight and followed him on the way.
Marcos capítulo 10, versículo 46. Entonces vinieron a Jericó, y al salir de Jericó, él y sus discípulos y una gran multitud, Bartimeo el ciego, hijo de Timeo, estaban sentados junto al camino, mendigando. Y oyendo que era Jesús Nazareno, comenzó a dar voces y a decir, Jesús, hijo de David, ten misericordia de mí. Y muchos le reprendían para que callase, pero él clamaba mucho más, hijo de David, ten misericordia de mí. Entonces Jesús, deteniéndose, mandó llamarle y llamaron al ciego diciéndole, ten confianza, levántate, te llama. Él entonces, arrojado su capa, se levantó y vino a Jesús. Respondiendo Jesús le dijo, ¿qué quieres que te haga? Y el ciego le dijo, maestro, que le cobra la vista. Y Jesús le dijo, vete, tu fe te ha salvado. y enseguida recobró la vista y seguía a Jesús en su camino.
Amen. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, Holy Spirit, Jesus, we already feel your presence, Lord. We have already proclaimed your authority over this place. I ask you in your name, Jesus, that we continue to listen to you, Lord, that we continue to allow our minds, our hearts, our entire beings to be open to what you have to say, Lord. I pray in the name of Jesus, Father God, that those who have came with burdens, those who have came with petitions, those who have came with uncertainties, that they continue to believe and have faith that you have purpose, that you will turn the bad into good, that the miracle is on its way, and that you are moving in every circumstance, Lord. I pray in the name of Jesus, Holy Spirit, that we do not leave this place without hope, that we continue to persevere and believe that you are in control. All this I pray in your mighty name, Jesus. Amen. You may be seated. Thank you, Brother Gustavo.
Gracias, hermano Gustavo,
for inviting me tonight.
Puedes tomar asiento, por favor, por invitarme en esta
noche. It is deeply an honor of mine.
Es un honor para mí.
To always be willing to serve.
Siempre servir.
God's people.
Al pueblo de Dios.
I am even deeply humbled.
Y me siento más humilde.
Because I have been able to bring a friend.
Que pude traer una amiga.
Who is very close to me.
Una íntima amiga.
And she was eager to come with me
y
to church tonight.
Dispuesta a acompañarme.
So thank you, Alejandra.
Gracias, Alejandra.
Please visit her, greet her.
Por favor, saludarla.
Because she's very excited to be with Templo Calvario tonight.
Está contenta porque está con nosotros.
The title of this message,
el título de este mensaje,
is called Have Persistent Faith.
Es tener la fe persistencia,
mercy,
misericordia,
and give thanks.
Y dar gracias.
Brother Gustavo told me that he felt the theme of Thanksgiving needs to be continued.
Él decía al hermano Gustavo que el tema de acción de gracias se tiene que continuar.
And as I was preparing, I asked God, God, what is it that you want? What is it that you want us to hear today?
Y mientras preparaba, le preguntaba al Señor, ¿qué quieres que hable en esta noche?
And the Holy Spirit brought me to this encounter.
Y el Espíritu Santo me trajo a este encuentro.
Of this man.
De este hombre.
Who was blind.
Que estaba ciego.
Who had nothing.
Que no tenía nada.
He was a beggar.
Era un mendigo.
And he encountered.
Y tuvo un encuentro.
The Messiah.
Con el Mesías,
who were to be the savior of the world.
Que sería el salvador del mundo.
It's amazing.
Es un milagro.
That if we study the encounters that Jesus has.
Cuando estudiamos los encuentros que Jesús tuvo.
That this one.
De este.
Of this man, Bartimaeus.
De este hombre, Bartimeo.
Jesus required of him.
El Señor requería de él.
To show faith.
Tener fe.
A lot of times.
Mucho.
Now more than ever.
Ahora más que nunca,
we as believers,
nosotros como creyentes,
are being tested of faith.
Estamos puestos bajo prueba.
God wants to see.
Dios quiere ver.
Everything that we have been taught.
Todo lo que hemos sido enseñados.
Lead to this point.
Llegando a este punto.
What has our faith shown?
¿Qué nos ha mostrado nuestra fe?
As followers of Jesus,
como seguidores de Jesús,
we continue to learn how to believe.
Aprendemos cómo creer.
And how to follow.
Cómo seguir.
Faith in Jesus,
la fe en Jesús,
transforma how we think.
¿Cómo pensamos?
I'm going to say that again. Faith in Jesus,
fe en Jesús,
transforma how we think.
¿Cómo pensamos?
Faith impacts
fe impactos
how we feel.
Impacta cómo sentimos.
Faith alters
la fe transforma
what we do.
Lo que hacemos.
And faith changes
la fe cambia
in what we
en qué
believe.
Creen.
See, when Jesus was coming to this city,
cuando Jesús venía a esta ciudad,
Bartimaeus had heard of who Jesus was.
Bartimeo escuchó quién era Jesús.
And there was something stirring in his spirit.
Y había algo que lo movía de su corazón.
That was getting him ready.
Que lo estaba preparando.
And I'm sure Bartimaeus didn't know what was going on.
Y estoy seguro que Bartimeo no sabía lo que estaba.
Because viendo. Remember, he was blind.
No olviden, está ciego.
And he was a beggar.
Y era un mendigo.
He was living on the streets. He had no money. He had
vivía
no food.
Calles, no tenía dinero, no tenía comida.
But there was something stirring inside of him. Bartimaeus did not go to church every Sunday. Bartimaeus wasn't being trained in the synagogue by the Pharisees. All Bartimaeus needed to know.
Solo Bartimeo.
Was the stories of this man named Jesus.
De la historia de este hombre llamado Jesús.
And Bartimeus knew, I gotta meet this guy.
Y Bartimeo dijo, tengo
There's
que
something
conocer.
About this man that's
Hay
different.
Algo de este hombre que tengo que conocer.
There's something stirring on our hearts tonight,
Hay algo que se está moviendo dentro de nuestra
We wouldn't be here tonight if there wasn't something stirring
no, no
in our hearts.
Aquí en esta noche, sino habría un mover de nuestro espíritu.
A lot of us are waiting on miracles.
Muchos estamos esperando milagros.
A lot of us are waiting for salvation for family members.
Estamos esperando la salvación para nuestras familias.
A lot of us are waiting for uncertainties to become certain once again.
Estamos esperando que las incertidumbres se conviertan en certezas.
And what is God telling us?
¿Y qué Dios nos dice?
I already had something stirring up inside of
you. Ya tengo algo que está moviendo dentro de ti.
Don't you feel it?
¿No lo sientes?
Don't you sense it? Haven't I sent that sister to you to remind you?
El Señor me ha enviado a ti para recordarte.
Haven't I allowed that brother to text you to remind you?
No te envió ese texto tu amigo hermano para invitar para recordarte.
God is continuing to stir up in our spirit for something that is great that is about to come.
Que Dios está haciendo moviendo nuestro ser para algo grande que ha de venir.
Three things we can learn from Bartimaeus.
Tres cosas que podemos aprender de
Number
Bartimaeus.
One.
Número uno.
Persistency.
Persistencia.
Blind Bartimaeus did not have anything.
Bartimeo, el ciego, no tenía nada.
But he had persistence and determination.
Pero era persistente y tenía determinación.
How sad is it that when Bartimaeus was trying to go to Jesus,
Qué triste que cuando Bartimaeus quiso acercarse a Jesús,
people were rebuking him.
La gente lo estaba reprendiendo.
And when I read this part of this encounter,
y cuando leía esta parte de este encuentro,
it really touched me.
Me impactó.
Because it reminded me,
porque me recordó,
that when we try to get closer to Jesus,
que cuando nos queremos acercar a Jesús,
we think we're going to have fans waiting for us.
Que pensamos que todo mundo no va a estar esperando.
We think we're going to have cheerleaders telling you, go for
que
it, go! We get enemies.
Enemigos son los que se aparecen.
We get haters.
Gente que odia.
We get judges.
Gente que nos juzga.
We get hypocrites.
Hipócritas.
Who have no love in their hearts.
Que no tienen amor en sus
and a desire for no one to be elevated.
Y no tienen deseo que nadie sea elevado.
Bartimaeus didn't care.
Pero Bartimeo no le importó.
Because he was persistent.
Porque él estaba persistiendo.
And because he was determined.
Y estaba determinado.
So I don't know what we are praying for. I don't know what we want God to do in our lives. But I am encouraging you tonight. That don't be discouraged because you got no one by your side.
No te desanimes si no hay nadie a tu par.
And don't be discouraged.
No seas desanimado.
And you get ugly looks looking right at your way. You just gotta focus on our Creator. And you gotta look at Jesus. And you gotta say, Jesus, you're the only one that can give me what I want, Lord. I'm going to you. And that's what he did. He cried out. Son of David! Remember, he's blind. All senses are working because he can't see. So he's going like this, and he don't care who you're about to run into. He's going like this. He has no idea where Jesus is.
Remember,
something is stirring inside of him. Something is moving inside of him. That's the Holy Spirit for us. We are part of that covenant. We got the Holy Spirit living in us. The second thing we can learn from
Bartimaeus.
Mercy.
Es humildad.
Bartimaeus was as low as you can think in the social system.
Él había bajado en la escala más baja que había.
But he even went lower.
Pero él conoció lo aún más bajo.
When he cried out, Son of David.
Cuando él clamó, Hijo de David.
He was acknowledging who Jesus is.
Él estaba reconociendo quién era Jesús.
But the whole world was blind.
Y el que estaba ciego era el mundo.
His eyes were seeing.
Porque él estaba viendo.
But the whole world was blind.
porque
Isn't
están
that haciendo. Amazing?
Es increíble, ¿no?
How the only person that was able to see who Jesus was.
El único que podía ver quién era Jesús.
Really couldn't see him.
En sí no podía ver.
And yet he knew.
Y aún así
just by hearing
solo para escuchar
what Peter was saying about
lo que se estaba diciendo de él.
That's my Savior.
Es mi Salvador.
That's my Messiah.
Él
and I'm going to him. And
a
I feel the power. And I feel the authority. That's who I've been waiting for. And that's who's going to set me free.
Y él me va a poner libertad.
So in that moment, Bartimaeus was showing mercy to Jesus.
En ese momento,
have mercy on me, Lord.
Pidiendo
misericordia. I am unworthy of your healing.
No merezco.
I am unworthy of giving my sight back.
No merezco que tú me cobras la vista.
You know, sickness
la enfermedad
has always been foreign to me.
Siempre ha sido algo foráneo.
And it's amazing how God works.
Es increíble cómo trabaja.
Church, I always said, I am very transparent.
Sí, siempre digo, soy transparente.
Because we got to learn from our life experiences what we're going through. We can't be secret. We got to be open about it. That's how we're going to build each other up. I've never experienced sickness in my own
no
life.
Sé lo que es enfermedad.
My family has never experienced sickness.
Mi familia nunca ha experimentado
to the extent
a la extensión de lo que estamos viviendo.
And I want to be honest with you, church.
Quiero ser franco con ustedes.
When 2020 hit,
cuando llegó el 2020,
I would pray to God and I would say, God, there's no way you're going to touch my family.
Yo oraba,
again, I'm going to be very transparent with you, church. So listen to what I'm about to say.
No quiero que toques a mi familia.
God, there's no way you're going to touch my family.
No quiero que toque mi familia.
Because we put you first.
Porque te ponemos por
my
encima.
Whole life,
toda mi
vida. I only know that 50-mile trip. 4 to 5 times a week sometimes.
Que es de ir de Fontana para acá.
I know what it is to put you first, God.
Yo sé lo que es ponerte
primero. I have seen car after car after car go down because there's 200,000 miles on the road. I have seen our family put you first. There is no way you're going to get us.
No nos vas a enfermar, Señor.
My family is sick.
Mi familia es enfermo.
I was diagnosed with diabetes.
Me diagnosticaron con diabetes.
In 2021.
En 2021.
I said, God.
Dije, Dios.
How could you?
¿Cómo es posible?
I did not have the spirit of Bartimaeus.
No tengo el espíritu Bartimeo.
Instead of humility.
En vez de ser humilde,
arrogance trying to cover my heart.
Arrogancia vino a conquistar.
My sister.
Mi hermanita.
Is very sick.
También estaba enfermita.
And a Sunday God allowed me to pray for her.
Y un domingo el Señor me permitió orar por ella.
And I remember praying and laying hands on her in this altar.
Y puse las manos sobre ella en este altar.
And I said, God.
Y dije, Señor.
Please.
Por favor.
Make her well again. Make her well again.
Sánala.
And you know what the Holy Spirit told me.
¿Sabes lo que me dijo el Espíritu Santo?
Trust in me.
Confía en mí.
For I want to reveal my glory.
Porque voy a revelar mi gloria.
Trust in me.
Confía en mí.
For I want to reveal my glory.
Porque voy a revelar mi gloria.
God doesn't give us what we want, church. If you think you come to church every Sunday is going to get you to get what you want, that's not what faith is about.
Dios no siempre nos da lo que queremos.
We're going to get sick.
No, vamos a enfermar.
Not because God wills it.
No porque el Señor lo quiera.
But because our bodies are sin.
Porque nuestros cuerpos son.
Sickness is because of sin.
Nuestros cuerpos están llenos de pecado.
Our perfect bodies that were once created has now been diluted.
Nuestros cuerpos perfectos que eran ahora están contaminados.
And whatever happens to us.
Y lo que me pudiera ocurrir a nosotros.
God promises.
Dios promete.
To reveal His glory.
Revelar su gloria.
However that entails.
Y eso implica.
Will I be healed from diabetes? I don't know.
Seré sano del diabetes, no
God has taught me so much
mucho
about self-control.
Sobre el dominio propio.
And he has revealed
me ha revelado
a deep dark sin that I have had. And he said, you need to rebuke them right now.
Y él me ha dicho,
get that out of you, because it's not from me.
Porque eso no viene de mí.
When we allow mercy
cuando nosotros permitimos que la
misericordia to overwhelm us,
nos llene,
we humble ourselves by God to allow him to show us what needs to change. And he's going to use anything that happens to us. And that goes back to what the Bible says. Do not worry. Because I'm going to turn whatever is bad and I'm going to make it good again. And why would God promise that? Because God is good. God is good. And someone is going to be touched by your story. And the other person is going to be touched by their story. So the Bartimaeus was like, God, Jesus, I need you to heal me, but you want to show mercy on me, Lord. Jesus was like, what?
Jesús dice, ¿qué?
Call that guy right now. I gotta talk to him. I gotta talk to him.
Quiero hablar con él.
So Bartimaeus was brought up to Jesus, and Jesus.
Trajeron Bartimeo delante de Jesús.
Clearly can see that he's blind.
Y todo el mundo puede ver que él está ciego.
What do you want from me?
¿Qué es lo que deseas de mí?
What do you want from me?
¿Qué deseas de mí?
You might think Jesus is blind. What do you think he wants from you?
Jesús está ciego. ¿Qué ha de pedirle?
Jesus wants a relationship with us.
Cristo quiere una relación.
He doesn't want your mom praying for your petitions. He doesn't want your wife kneeling at your bedside praying for your problems. Jesus wants to have that one-on-one communication with us. Jesus is all-knowing. Jesus knew far beyond the blindness what he wanted. But through that mercy and humility, Jesus' heart was taken back.
Jesús se conmovió.
And he said to Bartimaeus,
y le dijo,
what do you want from me?
¿Qué quieres de mí, Bartimeo?
Again, I was moved by the petitions tonight.
He sido conmovido por las peticiones.
God is moved.
Dios se mueve.
God is moved.
Dios se mueve.
By a heart
por nuestro corazón
full of humility and mercy.
Humildad.
God wants to hear from us.
Él quiere escuchar.
God wants to hear every single thing that is happening with us. So when Bartimaeus tells him,
entonces cuando Bartimeo le confiesa,
Rabbi, give me my sight.
Que pueda recobrar la
give
vista.
Give me my sight.
Que pueda recobrar la vista.
And what does Jesus say?
¿Y qué le dice Jesús?
He didn't even need to lay hands on him.
No tuvo que ni imponer las manos.
He said two powerful things.
Dijo dos cosas poderosas.
He first said,
lo primero que dijo,
go your way.
Vete.
Go your way.
Vete.
As I was studying these texts, this verse,
mientras estudiaba estos versículos,
biblical theologians say,
los teólogos dicen,
that it was interesting that Jesus first started off with that.
Es interesante cómo comenzó Jesús así.
Right away you might think, well, why didn't Jesus say, first you gotta follow me, you gotta follow A, B, C, X, Y, Z?
Jesús, ¿por qué no dijo, te tienes que hacer esto, esto, el otro, antes?
Jesus didn't say that.
Jesús no dice eso.
First Jesus says, go your way.
Vete.
Guess what, I'm gonna do what you want me to do.
Yo voy a hacer lo que tú me pidas.
But that doesn't mean you owe me anything.
No quiere decir que me debe nada.
You see, Jesus will never force himself.
Nunca se va a imponer en nosotros.
This is a personal relationship.
Esto es una relación.
I believe that personal. We are all here because we desire something of Jesus.
Creo que todos estamos aquí porque deseamos
algo de Jesús. Jesus knows that.
Y Jesús lo sabe.
Amen, 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 amen. Amen. Jesus is trying to teach us something.
Y el Señor nos quiere enseñar algo, Jesús.
God is going to heal my family.
Dios va a
cuidar. Don't worry.
No te preocupes.
God is going to heal my family.
Dios va a cuidar a mi familia.
Whether it's going to be in this life or in the next life, God is going to heal my family.
El Señor va a cuidar a mi familia.
But I don't serve God.
No sirvo al Señor.
Because I want Him to do something.
Porque quiero algo de
Él. I'm not up here every other month because I want God to take away my diabetes.
Yo no estoy aquí cada otro mes porque quiero que me quiten el diabetes.
I serve God.
Yo sirvo a Dios.
We are all here.
Todos estamos acá.
Because we love Jesus.
Porque amamos a Jesús.
We love Jesus.
Porque amamos a Jesús.
We love Him.
Lo amamos.
We love Him. I don't know how Jesus has done for you, but
no
Jesus
sé,
has done something that you just keep saying, I love you, Jesus.
Dices, yo te amo, Jesús.
Hey, I love you, God.
Te amo, Jesús.
But see, Jesus was testing Bartimaeus.
Jesús estaba probando a Bartimaeus.
What's going to happen when I heal him?
¿Qué va a pasar cuando lo cure?
What's going to happen when he answers our petitions tonight?
¿Qué vas a hacer tú cuando el Señor conteste tu petición?
In the name of Jesus, our petitions will be answered tonight.
Porque Dios va a contestar en esta noche.
Do we go back to living our sinful ways? Do we go back to living for
ourselves?
Do we leave Jesus once again, but then we'll come back when we're ready for another petition? He says, go your way.
Vete.
For your faith.
Tu fe.
Has healed you.
Te da sana.
The Bible says, immediately.
Dice la Biblia que enseguida.
Immediately.
Enseguida.
Bartimaeus was able to see Jesus.
Me cobró la vista.
And man, I would have done the same thing. I was able to gaze upon my Savior. The Bible says,
la Biblia
immediately
dice,
he was able to see.
Enseguida pudo ver.
And he followed Jesus. How many of us are going to continue to follow Jesus? How many of us are going to continue to obey Jesus? The last thing that we can learn from Bartimaeus is faithfulness. Bartimaeus showed his faithfulness to Jesus with action. And that action was to live his life
es vivir su vida
for him.
Para él.
Rise with me.
Pónganse de
pie. Rise with me.
Pónganse de pie.
How do we live for Jesus?
¿Cómo vivimos para Jesús?
We're living for him right now.
Estamos viviendo por él.
When we love our enemies.
Amando a nuestros enemigos,
we are living for Jesus.
Estamos viviendo para Jesús.
When we are merciful to one another,
cuando somos misericordiosos con unos con los y los otros,
we are living for Jesus.
Estamos caminando.
When we put others before ourselves,
cuando ponemos a otros sobre delante de nosotros,
we are living for Jesus.
Estamos viviendo para Jesús.
We choose.
Nosotros decidimos.
We are never forced.
Nunca se nos impone.
We choose to follow Him.
Nosotros
and forever,
y para siempre,
forever,
y para siempre,
we will reap.
Y estaremos gimiendo.
Greater things,
grandes cosas,
than what we think we need right now, than what we think we need,
de lo que necesitamos hoy,
right now,
hoy.
Pray with me.
Oremos.
Lord, I want to start, Father God, by asking you, Lord, thank you. Thank you for the salvation that we have. Thank you, Jesus, because I know, Lord, you have brought us to this moment. And only you know, Lord, what is going to happen tomorrow. But we trust in you, God. We choose to believe in you. We choose to follow you. And I ask you, Lord, for every heart, for every soul that is in this place, touch them, Lord. In the name of Jesus, we ask that you continue to be in control, that you continue to hold authority in this place. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for allowing us to be in the place of holies of holies. I want to ask if anyone here that has not accepted Jesus, if anyone here that has not accepted Jesus as their Savior, today is the day for salvation. I invite you to come. And we want to pray for you. We want to lead you in the prayer of salvation. Or if you want to raise your hand, I invite you now. If you want to receive yours. Jesus wants to live in your heart. He wants to show you that He has died for you, that He wants to bring eternal glory once more to be with you united. In the name of Jesus, Sister Belly, you're the leader in our prayer of salvation. My second call. And we need to be rededicated. If we feel that we need a fresh anointing, I invite everyone to come to this altar. I invite everyone to come and let us rejoice in what Jesus is and what Jesus will do. I don't know what we are needing from Him. I don't know what encounter that we need, but this altar is open. If you want to come forward, I'm just inviting you guys. The altar is open. In the name